Welcome back to this new video. In the last video, we have studied the tools to study nanomaterial structure of the nanoparticles, that is scanning, tunneling microscope and atomic force microscope. In this video, we are going to study properties, different properties of nanomaterials. Now, at first, we will discuss why there is change in properties, because we have seen we are just reducing the size of the particle. We are reducing to nano scale, and then there is drastic change in properties of nanomaterial. Okay, so why there is such a change in properties? So all these properties we are going to study: electrical, optical, thermal, etc. So first we study why there is change in properties. The first factor is the surface to volume ratio. Okay, we know surface area is R square. R is the dimension of the particle. Volume is R cube. So it is 1 by R. So from this equation, we can see that as we decrease the size of the particle, means as we decrease R, surface to volume ratio will increase. So what does it mean? Since surface to volume ratio increases, it means more number of atoms will be on the surface than into the volume of the material. Okay, so more number of particles will be on the surface. So we can see here, see if the size of the particle is a 3 nanometer, the 50% of the atoms will be on the surface. If size is a 10 nanometer, then 20% atoms will be on the surface and 80% will be into the volume. And if it is 30 nanometer, then only 5% will be on the surface. Okay, so the surface to volume ratio, so more number of atoms will be on the surface, that has major impact on the properties that we are going to study now. Okay, now second reason that we call as a quantum size effect. So it put limit on the motion of the particle, or we can say motion of the electrons. So this is the bulk material. So we can say that if any electron has a motion in this material, it is free to move in any one direction, x, y, z. This motion can be described in terms of x, y, z. So it can move anywhere in x, y, z direction. Now if it is quantum well, means one dimension reduced to nanoscale, so we get a plane structure. Now we can see it can move only in x and y direction, so degree of freedom is reduced here. If we consider this wire, quantum wire, means two dimensions are reduced to nanoscale, so it is free to move in only one direction. Okay, and this is the quantum dot. All the three dimensions are reduced to nanoscale, so it cannot have any motion in any direction. So we see as we decrease the size, the degree of freedom goes on reducing, so it puts limit on the motion of the electron. Okay, and the third factor is there is shift in conduction and valence band, and so there is change in forbidden gap. So we can see here, so this is the bulk material, so this is valence band, this is conduction band, and this is the energy gap. So this is isolated atom. Okay, so this is the valence energy level, and this is the next excited or conduction energy level, and this is the band gap. And this is our nanoparticle. So what is the peculiarity of nanoparticle? It is neither bulk, it is nor isolated atom. So it is intermediate state. It is made up of few atoms. Okay, so we do not have the band, energy band, as in case of bulk, but we have a set of energy levels. So this is the set of energy levels for valence energy levels, and this is the set of conduction energy level, and this is the band gap. So we can see here, as compared to bulk, there is increase in band gap. Okay, so there is increase in surface to volume ratio, there is decrease in degree of freedom, or it reduces the it, or it puts limit on the motion of the electrons in the nanoparticle. And third important, there is change in energy band structure, or there is increase in energy band gap. Okay, and due to these three reasons, there is drastic change in properties of nanoparticles, or when we reduce the size of the particle, there is drastic change, we can see. So one by one, we will discuss now different properties. So first we study electrical conductivity. Now we can say there is change in conductivity of a material when we decrease the size, or when it becomes nanoparticle. So one example we can give, we know the plastic is insulating, but plastic nanotubes are good conductors. So there is change in conductivity at nanoscale. The second important property is the Coulomb blockade effect. So what is the Coulomb blockade effect? So here we construct the capacitor, you know, parallel plate capacitor, the two metallic plates separated by insulating layer. Now the it is rule of thumb that capacitance decreases with size. Now at a nanoscale, that insulating layer is very thin. Now you know parallel plate capacitor, this insulating layer is very thin, that is of the order of nanometer. So now we know if the two conducting wires they are connected, they are separated by nanometer distance, there is tunneling of electron. Okay, so here also there is tunneling, and now it is according to this rule, the capacitance will be very small if this insulating layer is nanometer. Now this is the equation we know, C is equal to Q by V. So as C increases, V will also increase. Okay, so even a single electron tunneling, even one electron, it crosses that insulating barrier, the measurable voltage will be developed, or very large voltage will be developed. Okay, and due to this large voltage, this is a repulsive voltage, so it prevents further tunneling of electrons. So once one electron crosses the barrier, next electron cannot cross the barrier. So this is called as Coulomb blockade effect. So this is about the electrical properties. I will repeat. First, there is change in conductivity at nanoscale. Example, plastic nanotube. And second is the Coulomb blockade effect. When the insulating layer of capacitor is very thin in nanometer, single electron tunneling will develop large voltage, and that prevents further tunneling of electron, and that is called as Coulomb blockade effect. It means further electrons are blocked. They are prevented, means they are blocked from tunneling. Okay. So this is electrical conductivity. Okay. Now next property is the optical properties. Now optical properties we study separately for semiconductor and metal. Now we have seen that for semiconductor, there is widening of energy gap at nanoscale, we have seen. And due to widening of energy gap, the absorption peak is shifted to shorter wavelength or higher frequency side. We know the energy equal to band gap is absorbed. So absorption peak is maximum when energy of the incident light is equal to band gap. We know that. So that absorption peak is shifted to blue side. So that is called as a blue shift. Then we consider the metal. Now we know in the metal there are large number of free electrons. Now when we consider the nanoparticle, now according to surface to volume ratio, more number of electrons will be on the surface. These free electrons will be on the surface. So these are called as surface plasmons. You know, plasmon is a charged particle. So these particles are on the surface, so we call as surface plasmons. Now when the light is incident on metal nanoparticle, then these electrons, surface plasmons, they are put into vibration, they start vibration. So these electrons on the surface, we call them as electron cloud, because this particle is very small in size, So we call them as a electron cloud. So this electron cloud or surface plasmons, it is set into vibration. Okay. Now we know every object, physical object, has its own frequency of vibration, natural frequency. So when the incident light, frequency of incident light and the natural frequency of the electron cloud matches, then this electron cloud, it vibrates with maximum amplitude. Got it? See, this is the electric field vector of incident light. We know because light is a electromagnetic. So due to this electric field, this electron cloud is put into vibration. When the frequency of incident light matches with the frequency of electron cloud, it vibrates with maximum amplitude, and this is called as surface plasmon response. Okay, so at this situation, surface plasmon resonance, the maximum absorption occurs. Okay, and again, this natural frequency, we know it depends on the size. So as we change the size of nanoparticle, its natural frequency will change and the absorption frequency will also change. Okay, so these are about optical properties. Okay, so we stop here. Okay, and the next properties we will discuss in the next video. Next properties, these are thermal, magnetic, chemical, etc., that we will discuss in the next. Okay, thank you.